At its creators, one Trevor Horn, high priest of production, butcher of bleep, one Paul Morley, juju of journalism, hewer of hype, invisible silence, the dogs have learned their master's tricks. Their bark is bustier than bow wow wow. In Central Park, they make a brave face. Good luck to their honor.
But we're not a conventional pop group because we don't have a singer. We don't have spiky hair or any kind of fashion image. And we don't really record songs. If you don't have any words, you can still be misinterpreted, but it's probably less dangerous. You have to find hook lines in drum sounds and construct different structures, because you don't have verses and choruses necessarily. We find Peter Gunn to be really quite an avant-garde kind of tune, because it's based around a very heavy bass riff. And on top of this bass riff, there's this kind of tune, which is kind of a tune and kind of a solo. So in the confines of this number, it seemed to us that we could probably do something of our own thing whilst retaining the atmosphere and the vibe of the old track. It's not a bad thing to be a dance band.
No, we'd rather that than rigor mortis.
Well, that way you really have soul, you know, if you're a dance band. You get to people through their feet. So it must involve soul, isn't it? He's a performer. He performed the piece. We didn't kind of ask him to do one bar and then loop it up and stick it in the fairlight and put it back on the track. He played the track from start to finish. We're a great believer in great musicians, great musicianship and the excitement of performance. And Dwayne's certainly an exciting performer. Trevor Horn wasn't Art of Noise. Trevor Horn was part of Art of Noise for a while.
True.
I mean, we don't want to be in the business of slagging him off.
But we will if you want.
But you don't speak to him anymore, do you?
No, he doesn't speak to us.
I'm sure if he phoned us up, we would speak to him.
We'd speak to him. Because we're quite liberal with the people we speak to.
A video is one interpretation of the song. We have a slightly ambivalent attitude towards videos because we think in many respects, it destroys people's imaginative interpretation of what a song might be about. Mm-hmm. And I'm not really in favor of a very literal translation of a video.
McLaren's Buffalo Gals, and Jeczalik started as a Fairlight computer virtuoso. The two comment on the conflict between technology and art.
I think you're being unreasonable to both musicians and technical personnel by saying they're one or the other. I think we're a meeting ground of both both categories of I don't think you should draw a distinguishing line between the two. The two go hand in hand. The band loved it.
Our only input into it was he sent us the tape that he'd made. We looked at it and we said, God, this is great. Unfortunately, our record company didn't like it.
The DT at the time.
Though they
why not?
Well, they took it rather seriously. They thought it was the idea of breaking up the past, breaking up the classical instruments. They didn't see the humour in it, basically. They thought it was too violent. Though they've since been very happy to collect many awards for it.
The newest version of Close to the Edit used animation and director Andy Morahan.
Yeah. The edit, which marked the directorial debut of Zbigniew Rybczynski.
We make music, you see, in our various capacities, both as the art annoyers and producers, arrangers and engineers and all that sort of business. And we tend to like to entrust our video making to people who are perhaps more capable than us, because we're busy doing, making records. Cue for wind noise. So Zbig was the obvious choice.